Welcome to the third part of our LLM mini-series, which is about converting data in an unstructured form, in particular text, into some structured form. And for that, we prepared a particular dataset. So what you can see here is the hotel requests dataset that we prepared artificially with the self-instruction method. Check out the paper if you're interested in more. So basically, what you do is you prepare some seed instructions initially. So even if you don't have a lot of data, you can do this. And then take a really strong large language model and generate more text, and then make sure the data that is created matches a certain structure and also is not too similar to the existing samples. So let's open the first one. What we have here is a hotel request text that you would send maybe to a hotel or to a booking agent, which is here. Hello, I'm in need of booking a hotel for my upcoming trip, and so on. It states a date, a name, a location, and the hotel itself. So what we did is we used this data set to train, or to be more specific, to fine-tune an existing LLM to perform this task for us. Now you might think, well, can I use ChatGPT for that directly? Well, you could, but sometimes you're not able to do. And also, smaller LLMs in general, if it's ChatGPT or your own large language model, smaller LLMs have a lot of a lower memory footprint, and therefore they're usually faster and a lot less expensive to run. One example of this is the Falcon 1B model. So we took that and we quantized it and fine-tuned it in 8-bit, meaning from this 2.6.2 gigabytes, you almost shave off another half of it. So in the end, this is really a small scale language model that is able to perform this task without any complex prompting strategies. The final model that results from this is in this repository on Hugging Face. Here you have an overview of the configuration, which states, okay, it's loaded in 8-bit. It's using the bits and bytes library. And what you see here, if you click on the files, there's only two specific files, which is the adapter config and the adapter model, and they're both very small. And the reason for that is that we used LoRA, or low rank adaptation, which means that you only train additional matrices on top of some of the matrices. Therefore, you can train a model without modifying its original weights and only obtaining these adapters afterwards. And this model is also deployed. It runs on a really small GPU, and it was also trained on a small GPU, just a T4, and for 10 epochs, which took about 10 minutes. So let's check out our corresponding Hugging Face space where this is visualized. So on the left-hand side, we have a request for the hotel. So let's enter an example request. And now we can basically fire this off. And what you will see here now, if you read the text already, okay, there is somebody called Julian Ribeiro. There is also a hotel called Mandarin Oriental. And this person wants to book it on the 6th of September in 2021. And the location overall is Paris and France. So the nice thing about these large language models is, of course, they generalize a lot better than smaller transformers. So what you can do with, for example, you can say, dear sir, madam, I am Michael Jordan. So this would be now the appropriate guest name, since we remove the rest. And as we can see here, does this exactly. Or of course, you can also remove some text and say, okay, let me take the Mandarin Oriental in Munich, for example. And it takes this Munich, Germany, Mandarin Oriental. Everything is correct now. You can even move the date, take a different style of date. Let's say 7th of July, 2023. And here we go. Also takes that. So yeah, this is basically just a quick demonstration but it's applicable to a lot of different scenarios, especially in the realm of standardizations or basically any type of annotations. Hope you enjoyed the video.